In this session, we're going to study the measurement of capacitance of a capacitor using ballistic galvanometer. The circuit is very simple. In this circuit, it contains a battery of EMF V. There are two resistors, capital R and small r. The value of capital R is 10,000 ohm and the value of small r is 1 ohm. Circuit contains capacitor and a ballistic galvanometer. This capacitor can be charged by using this Morse key. If you press a Morse key, that is, if P is in contact, then Q will be opened, that is no contact, capacitor will be charged through a potential of V. When Q is in contact, that is P is opened, then capacitor will be discharged through this ballistic galvanometer. When P and Q are opened and key K is closed, let IG be the small current flows through this ballistic galvanometer. Initially, let us say K is open. A Morse key P is pressed and Q is open. This capacitor is charged, a potential difference of V. Then I am reducing this circuit into this equivalent circuit. In this circuit, there are two components, capital R and C. They are parallel to each other and they are parallel to the battery of EMF V. This resistor R is parallel to this battery. Therefore, EMF V is equal to I into R. We know that from the definition of capacitance of a capacitor, we can write Q is equal to C V. This V is nothing but I into R. So I can write Q is equal to C I R. Let us take this equation as 1. When P is released or opened and Q is closed or Q makes a contact. Now capacitor gets discharged through this ballistic galvanometer. When capacitor discharges through this ballistic galvanometer, let theta 1 be the first deflection observed through this ballistic galvanometer. I'm taking theta 1 as the first deflection observed through this ballistic galvanometer. From the theory of ballistic galvanometer, we know that if Q amount of charges flows through the ballistic galvanometer, then the expression for Q is given by C by BAN T by 2 pi theta 1 into 1 plus lambda by 2, where C is coupled per unit twist, B is magnetic field, A is area of the coil in the BG, N is number of turns in the coil, T is time period of oscillation, 2 pi is constant, and this lambda is logarithmic decrement. Let us take this as equation 2. From equation 1 and 2, we can observe that left hand sides are equal, so we can equate right hand sides. By equating, we'll get this expression. Let us simplify this. So here, this C is equal to C by BAN T by 2 pi theta 1 into 1 plus lambda by 2 divided by I R. Let us take this as equation 3. In next part, when the key K is closed and P and Q are open from the Morse key. Here, that Morse key is excluded from the diagram. When the key K is closed, we can see from this diagram, ballistic galvanometer and fractional resistor small r are parallel to each other. Since they are parallel, we can say that potential difference across this BG is equal to potential difference across this small resistor. That is, PD across R is equal to PD across ballistic galvanometer. Here, this I is a steady current flowing through this capital R. At this junction, at this node, this current divided into two parts. If Ig is the current flowing through this BG, then remaining current through this small r is I minus Ig. So, we can write potential difference across small r as I minus Ig into small r. The potential difference across BG is Ig into capital G. So, here this capital G is resistance of the ballistic galvanometer. From this, PD across small r is equal to PD across ballistic galvanometer. So we can write I minus Ig into small r, which is equal to Ig into capital G. Simplifying this, multiplying this small r to this, you get Ir minus Ig into small r, which is equal to Ig into capital G. Therefore, expression for this Ig is equal to IR divided by G plus R. When Ig current flows through ballistic galvanometer, let theta be the deflection observed in the ballistic galvanometer. Then moment of a couple can be written as tau is equal to BAN into Ig, where this tau can be written as C into theta. Here C is coupled per unit twist. By equating these two equations, we write C theta is equal to BAN into Ig, that is BAN into Ig. Simplifying this equation, C by BAN, which is equal to IR divided by G plus R into theta. I am substituting the value for this Ig. Ig is IR divided by G plus R. C by BAN is equal to this expression. Now we have two equations. C by BAN is equal to this, and C is equal to C by BAN T by 2 pi theta 1 into 1 plus lambda by 2 divided by I into R. So here we can observe C by BAN. We can substitute this C by BAN in this expression. We can substitute C by BAN as this in this equation. By substituting this in equation 3, I can get this expression. C is equal to T by 2 pi R divided by G plus R into capital R theta 1 into 1 plus lambda by 2 divided by theta. Here, by knowing all these parameters, capital T, G, small r, capital R, theta 1, theta and logarithmic decrement lambda, we can calculate the capacitance of a capacitor. Thank you.